At the time I came to Champaign, I had already done a few notable things. I had already toured the world with Frank Zappa and with David Bowie. And I'm going to say, yes, Talking Heads and even King Crimson. So the first four major things that linked my career and really kickstarted me were already in gear. I moved here because I was working with some musicians and some friends, and they were on my first solo album, and they wanted to move here. I don't know why, but I said, well, if you guys are moving, I'm moving too. And also because I had been here many times playing here, primarily at a club that was here called Mabel's, and I always liked it here. I always thought, well, you know, Champaign, Urbana has a real youthful vibe to it. It's about education. It's about, you know, energy and things. And there was a good music scene all the time. So when my friends decided, let's move en masse, I joined in. Got a house over in Urbana by Carl Park, and I loved it there. It was really beautiful, cobblestone streets. And my house was right across from the park itself. And every Sunday, for the 5 years that I lived here, we had a running volleyball game. Anyone could come. Anyone was allowed to join in. They had a really nicely done volleyball section there with wood chips and things. So all Sunday long, every Sunday, we'd have tons of people come by and play. I've always preferred more places where you can just be yourself. I mean, I'm not a big city person. I get plenty of that in all my travels around the world. And I like big cities to be in for a little while and work in. But I've always liked a more private thing where you can grow a garden and you can have a dog. And, you know, those kinds of things have been an important way to ground myself, you know. And so I've always liked this city, and I now live in Mount Juliet, Tennessee, which is outside of Nashville, which is a similar type of thing, you know. But Nashville has grown up a lot in the 18 years I've been there. But I don't think they're unsimilar. You know, you have Vanderbilt University there and Belmont College, and it's, you know, another one of those thriving, youthful kind of scenes. One of the people who moved here along with me was my recording engineer. His name is Rich Denhart, and he had gotten in collusion with some people here who owned a studio called Creative Audio. And they said, well, you know, you can have time there and you can, you know, you don't have to rush. It's not going to be an expensive thing. So it was very important to me to have that at that point. I was making my third solo record when I first arrived here. And it turned out that I wanted to make a record that was kind of orchestral, off the wall, mostly orchestral, but done with guitars. It wasn't the normal thing. It wasn't songs, and it wasn't pop music, and it wasn't even King Crimson like. It was a very different brand of music. And I was really fortunate to have that kind of studio to go to, because it was a comfortable thing, a low pressure zone, you know. I would ride my bike over to it every day, and me and Rich would just work, and we'd get things done, and then, you know, it was fun. It was like building something, you know, and you weren't worrying about all the other things that sometimes get in the way of creativity, you know, the record labels, desires, or the money involved, or whatever. This was just something we thought, well, we're just going to do this and get it done as long as we... Because I was already out doing other things that were earning me a living, so I was well, you know, able to do that. For me personally, it was a nice place to be, because I could be myself here and create and not spend a fortune doing it and feel comfortable doing it. So it was a good time in my life. I remember being, you know, fairly inspired while I was here. Did a lot of work. I started a band called The Bears while I was here, three of my friends from Cincinnati. And we always rehearsed and recorded in my rehearsal place here. And then, of course, I had King Crimson. So there was this influx of players and people that I knew, and we'd always end up at somewhere having drinks, the Esquire Lounge or Mabel's or somewhere, and just a lot of those kind of fun moments. They're not necessarily fun if you weren't there. I remember one night we went to Mabel's, and Robert Fripp was there with us, and, you know, he's notoriously doesn't want anyone to speak to him or anything, so he had on a badge that said, "I am not Robert Fripp." And people kept coming up to me and saying, is that guy him? Yeah, but just don't talk to him. Just leave him alone. But we had a lot of fun times, like crazy, you know. I mean, we would play all day and then go out and have some drinks and just go wild. It was fun. We were young, you know. You do have one really good asset, and that is the university. I mean, you know, with the university, you get all these wonderful new college kids every year, so there's bound to be a need for music and entertainment, and you've got some great facility here that the university has, like the Cranford Arts Center is fabulous, you know. So I think that's another part of it. Having a city that's built around education is part of it.